to fall. We've had nearly 2.5 feet of snow in the last 3 days. However, the track is in pretty good shape today. It is extremely fast. This is USA's number one sled. The driver is Brent Rushlaw, national two-man champion 5 times. He's been sledding for over 10 years. Only Bob Driver in 3 straight Olympics in 1980. Brent finished impressively in the Winter Olympics with a strong 6th place. He is an outstanding pilot. Brent Rushlaw has one of the best safety records in the sport. He's also a spectacular driver. He's tipped his sled only once in his career. It was in driver's course in Cortina in 1981 at the World Cup. Rushlaw was in 4th place when he lost control heading into the famous Cristallo curve. His runners left the ice into the air. He flew to the lip and banged his head. He suffered a concussion, but it could have been much worse. He'd gone faster than he'd ever gone before. Brent Rushlaw, you saw his brakeman as Jimmy Tyler. Jimmy's brother Joe rode with Rushlaw in the 1980 games.
Brent and Jimmy had a 668 start time. Yesterday was their best start time. Everybody else improved their starts by 400 or 500, 600. Let's see what they do here. 16th place after the first or the second heat. I don't think Brent really likes that position. Let's watch their start time. 667, they're only 100 better. And they're giving up 30 hundredths right at the start, and that transcends in bobsledding. I keep mentioning the 3 times at the bottom. And I'll tell you, Timmy, the snow is really falling here at Trebevichno.
They call Brent Rushlaw the stuntman. Once he drove off a bridge into an icy water from 50 feet, drove his car from upstate New York to New York City with no brakes, pitched a perfect game against John Morgan.
Yeah, Brent's quite an athlete. I've done a lot of things with him in my lifetime. Let's watch for split time, 32.91, 33.74. It's considerably faster than his split time yesterday. Brent, I think, will be doing a little bit better next week at a 4-man. He's got a very competitive sled.
John, we've seen the time for Brent Rushlaw in the first 2 heats. We've seen Freddie Fritsch and Wayne Dietley. Why aren't the Americans as strong as they were in the early years of the sport?
Well, I really think that Europe, where there's so many bob runs, there's his finish time, 52.35. That's Brent's fastest time ever. That's a good time for Brent. That's 7,500 hundredths better than his time yesterday. But again, in New York, New England, and Pennsylvania, there's only one bob run of that area.
Brent Rushlaw, USA number one. This is the Soviet Union's number one sled. You're looking at Yanis Kippers, the Russian driver. They call him the professor. Now, these red sleds are the fastest in the two-man game today, but they are not outstanding drivers. The brakeman, Ivar Schneps.
They're in 5th place at the end of 2 heats, and I tell you, he had the fastest time in the 2nd heat yesterday, Timmy. The 1st heat, though, that Soviet pilot aspect came into play, and he had a terrible 1st heat.
He had a push time of 6.38. They are track athletes. They should improve upon that today. They should also have faster times.
Now, these guys here are the best starting two-man bobsled team in the world. Watch the accelerations they come off the block.
Getting mentally prepared. The explosion. Now they go 15 meters before they break the electric eye. Now they go 64 meters. Watch the time. The best on the left, 6.38. Their time, 6.39.
Hey, the Russians, we came in here thinking the Russians were the best starting teams in the world. They have not been as competitive at the start as we'd like them to be.
John, sometimes these fins hit the side of the ice. It has to slow you down.
Well, again, that's the drivers. The Russians, they've got great sleds, great start times, but driving down the course, they aren't as quick. Let's see what he can do here. Now, he's really got to have a good split time here to make up some time on that East German. And let's watch for 32.91, 32.98, not bad, but this is where they get a little slow down here.
The East Germans, more experienced pilots. The Soviet Union with the faster sleds. They come into the labyrinth, 316 meters to go.
He lost a little bit of time there in the labyrinth. Let's watch him here in the finish corner. He needs a good time to move up.
But he's flying around the final whip around. The time to the left, the time to beat. His time, 51.30. That'll put him in 3rd place, John.
51.30, very competitive time. That might move him up ahead of Hillebrand. We'll have to see what Hillebrand does in the future here.
Puts him in 3rd place. Cumulative time is not as good, I'm sure, as they would want it after 3 heats.
Their times would be a lot worse, Tim, if they didn't have these great start times at the top. These two guys are probably the greatest starting two-man team in the world. Look at their rhythm. Look at their hips. Now watch how they come out. Look at the brakemen. Watch their feet coming out at the same time. Again, these guys are the greatest starting team in the world.
This is Switzerland's number one sled. Hans Hildebrand's the driver. He's 39 years old and still very much in the hunt. He missed a bronze medal at the 1980 Olympics in Lake Placid by just 24 hundredths of a second over the 4 runs. His brakeman, Meinrad Müller.
Okay, Hillebrand's got to watch out because the Soviets that just came down, Kippers is only 400 behind him after 2 heats, and he just had a very good heat. Hillebrand drives in fourth place going into this third heat. He needs a good time of low 51 to maintain his spot.
He has the two East Germans and the Soviets, number one sled in front of him. His push time, 6.47. It's competitive.
Very competitive for Hillebrand, considering he was in the 50s yesterday. Hillebrand is a great pilot down this course. But boy, the snow has got to be affecting these guys coming down late in this heat, Timmy.
Hildebrand turned over on Matt Van Hovenberg in the 83 Worlds. This is a tougher course, maybe down low, John, with the tight turns.
5, 6, and 7. This is the driver's course. Hillebrand's a good pilot. Coming up to curve 7, this is where his countryman Piesler tipped over. Let's look at his foot time. 32.91, 33.07, not a bad time.
He has a great touch for a pilot. He lets the sled do most of the work. He steers only when he has to.
He's 900 behind the Russian. It's a little bit behind him here. That's not good for him. Quick hands here in the finish quarter. He's going to need them.
The final curve, Brua Downs with a time, 51.35. That'll put him in fourth place. His cumulative time, 2 minutes, 35 seconds, and 29 hundredths.
That puts him 1/100 behind the Russian.
This is Zintas Igmanis driving the Soviets' number two sled. He's only been bobsledding since 1980. In the 1982, Igmanis finished seventh in the four-man world championships. His brakeman, Vladimir Alexandrov, he's a former javelin thrower. This is their first Olympic bob appearance.
These Soviets right here need a tremendous heat to overtake Lehman, the East German who's in second place. He's got to watch out because if he falters at all, Kippers, his countryman, could go by him also. So a lot of pressure here on this Soviet to stay in the medal.
Both Soviet drivers from Latvia. The push time, you'll see his on the right. The time on the left, the best push time of the third heat.
6:40, that's his best start time of the competition. Let's see if he doesn't make any mistakes up top. He's going to make mistakes right here in the straightaway. He's clean so far, Timmy.
Good speed. These shark sleds, the driver and the brakeman, much more compact. The driver has only the eyes here.
Yes, the brakeman adds the aerodynamics sitting right behind the driver. Let's watch this foot time. Sub 33 here. He's sub 30, 32.95. He's close. He needs an excellent heat here to keep his medal chances.
Now he's coming down to the final turns. This is where the Soviets have had some trouble and lost some time.
He looks pretty good here. Again, he needs a good heater. Low, low 51 to keep his medal hopes up there.
Through the turn test before the final curve, through and down with a time, 51.24. That'll put him in third place.
That'll keep him ahead of his countrymen, but not going to let him move up ahead of the East Germans.
That's right, John. Wolfgang Hoppe is still in first place, followed by his East German countryman Bernhard Lehmann. The Soviets are third and fourth, with less than a second separating the top four spots in the final heat yet to come.